Animals and plants have always coexisted. In the past 40, 50 years, what we've done in modern agriculture is kind of separated the two. We slowly depleted the biodiversity in our soil. What we're trying to do is improve yield and quality by working to integrate nature in our process of producing our crops. We're also introducing a lot of technologies to be able to better manage our crop. We already know today that in some region of the world, there are crises out there where the system can no longer feed people. We have no choice. We have only one planet. The majority of our food comes from probably, 12 inches of soil. We need to make sure that we maintain that soil as productive as possible. The beauty of potatoes, it's a crop that's extremely nutritious. It provides not only a good source of carbohydrate, but also of proteins and minerals. So I've been actually working my entire career, and I did my master's and PhD studying potatoes. So for me, potato is truly my passion. It's also a chance for me to kind of bring ecology at the farm level. What we've done in terms of agriculture and the impact is we've lost a lot of productivity in our soil. We have basically lost our organic matter through the tillage, to the introduction of a lot of synthetic products, especially fertilizer. If you look at most of the developing world, what we see as a trend is that our potato yields have increased in the past 30 years, but for the past 10 years, what we're seeing is either a plateauing or a decrease in yield. And a lot of that has to do with the soil itself. If your yield keeps decreasing and your input increases, your margins shrink. We want to make sure that we are able to provide practices and technologies that can be useful for our growers. The best definition of regenerative agriculture lies in the concept of regenerating, to bring back all that diversity, all that life, and that all that soil functionality back into into the soil that we're growing crops. What we're trying to do and accomplish with our rotation, basically growing our crop of interest, which is the potatoes, and then of being able to grow another crop. By planting cover crop, we're protecting our ground, so we're preventing elements that would favor soil erosion. There's a lot of benefit of increasing your rotation, and especially increasing the diversity of these types of crops that have a different root structure. That means that they'll be able to go at different depth in the soil, and they will feed different type of microorganism. So this is a way for us to build soil that would be naturally resistant and bringing back as much biodiversity in our soil to be able to naturally combat the pests and diseases. We're also introducing a lot of technologies, so that's going to help us really reduce our carbon footprint. You'll find that our tractor are a little weird looking. We've aligned our wheels and all the equipment we're using to limit the impact that equipment has on soil, allowing basically more airspace to be created in our soil. So our need for tillage is greatly reduced. The solar panel is for us to be able to produce our own energy at the farm. We want to be able to power our irrigation system with the solar panels. In other farms, for instance, all of Northern Europe, there's a lot more wind power there, and that might have a better fit for that type of environment. And the more insight and the more we learn, the more I think we'll be able to see the improvements. The idea is for us to be able to cover globally all of the ecological system to be able to bring the technologies and practices all around the world. The future is to establish those farms in different parts of the world where climate and growing conditions are very different. But it's a combination of practices, of technologies, and know-how to be able to transfer to our growers. To change your practices that you've done for 60, 70 years, we understand that the transition needs to be financed, because it's very important to be able to talk to these different levels, government, institution, and also putting money directly on the table to be able to assist in that transition. Depending on the regions, we've got different means of doing it. In some cases, are we actually promoting growers using those practices and incentivizing them through pricing? In other regions, are working with banks to be able to allow growers to access capital at a reduced price as they transition towards this new type of agriculture. Potato in the human diet is very important. So in terms of the future of potato, to be able to mitigate our impact on climate, we need to promote biodiversity and making sure that we are increasing stability in our production system. I think the biggest thing that we need to do is start implementing practices that we know are fairly easy to do that will have a major impact.